folks. I'm Pop Haydn. We have another little experiment with magnetized water that's really fun and interesting, and you can do it at home. All you need for this is a little magnet. This is like a little round magnet with a hole in the center. It's a refrigerator magnet. And I've got another little cylindrical magnet, which I've used some sealant wax to attach to a piece of string. And of course, those will attract, like so. And we need some magnetized water. Now, I always use Pop Haydn's original magnetized water from California, of course. It's the most highly magnetized water available in the marketplace today. But you can use any magnetized water that's sufficiently strong. This magnetized water, I'll tell you the truth, it tastes so good. Yes, and it's good for you, too. And we're just going to fill a little glass with it, like so. Now, we're going to also need a piece of cardboard. Now, this is what's called an artist board or paint board. It's a little piece of cardboard covered with canvas, and that canvas is not very absorbent. So that makes it perfect for an experiment with water like this. You can get those at any artist supply. And we just simply place the cardboard over the magnet like so. Now we could find that magnet really pretty easily with the magnet on the string. I just hold this one over here and look, see there it goes, it points it right out. So we can find it that way, but there's another way we can do it, and that's with a little magnetized water. I'm going to get this dropper filled with water, and then I'm going to come over here and look. We're just going to put a little. All right. So now you see here as we drop water onto here, it finds the magnet. It takes its shape around the magnet. This is not only because it's magnetized water and that's drawn into the magnetic field of the magnet under the card, but because it is highly structured water, because it is magnetized water, it has a much higher surface tension than ordinary water. That's what helps it hold this shape, this little strange little donut shape. But as we pour more water in, you'll see that hole should fill in. There's be more water than the magnet can hold. And there it goes, it closes up. Now it's still a little thinner there in the middle than it is on the outside. But as we add more water to here, we're going to have more water than the magnet can hold even within the field of its outside edges. And that's when things get kind of interesting. So now here, there's more water here, really, as you can see the magnet's barely able to hold on to it. When I take this little magnet, it will fight with the big magnet over the water, and it will try and pull the water away from it like that, see? You can't do this except with magnetized water. But it looks very magical, I think. This is what happens with magnetized water. Water actually drawn by magnetism from one magnet to another. And that's it, folks. That's magnetized water. It's easy to do this trick. You can show it to your friends. It looks kind of magical, I think. It's very interesting thing to do. It works best with, it won't work with anything that's not magnetized. You can use any magnetized water. But it works best, I think, with Pop Haydn's original magnetized water from California. I hope you've enjoyed this little experiment. Have fun with it. Let me know what you think and check other experiments like this out at pophaydn.com.